Orders, you got any rounds left while holding? Is there any way you can turn around and get a couple rounds going the other way? If you can, give me a screen of Willie Pete from 160 to 200, range 600 meters.
Gonna be pretty far off.
Copy that.
I just want a screen of Willie Pete all through those trees there.
Copy that.
Roger, charge medium.
You want to talk about accurate? Fucking Wahali was on the fucking ball with those mortar missions. I was like, you know, hey, look, there's infantry up there on the hill. And then, like, literally 30, 40 seconds later, I was already seeing mortar rounds drop. You know, really accurate fire. I was like, fucking, like, back on it.
So there was a hill at 300, we were putting a bunch of shells on, and then we'd hear that there's some action over near 200, 220, put some shells there. So it got to the point where we had to react quickly on those things because we knew that nobody else was helping those people, that the arty rounds were going somewhere else.
The medics, Thok, Skin, and Sergeant Slaughter, they did a real kick-ass job. It was crazy. The medics, they really had their job cut out for them.
Hey, are you guys fucked up over here?
Slaughter, dude.
Yeah, I'm fucked up.
Medics, your helos are inbound. Your medevac helos are inbound.
Hear me.
Are all these guys dead?
Yeah, they're all dead.
That little body bag area, the little collection zone there that they had of all the casualties, that was very well on their part.
Am I?
No.
Alright, we have two guys over to the right.
Watch out, we're Willie Pete to our southwest.
Hold on. Sorry, my acre's a little messed up right now, but of course, once target 6 is dealt with, get some rounds on target 7 into the wood line to the west of it. Fuck.
What?
Jake, can you hear me?
Yeah, I think my biggest thing was that is the 60s were so loud that nobody could talk to each other or hear the radios, so we're sitting there and, like, literally my wife came here and closed the door to my office because I was sitting here yelling so loud, just trying to talk to people over the 60s.
Alright, good enough.
Hear me?
Sure.
Man, fuck, man. They even talk about...
I do credit everyone that was flying for a good job, because flying in the pitch black conditions is nowhere easy. Landing in pitch black conditions is nowhere easy. I was surprised we didn't have as many aircraft losses as we did.
By the end of the mission, I was down to less than a fifth, maybe a sixth of fuel.
And when I was in that helo, I couldn't see anything. All I could see was stars. I couldn't even see the instruments. I couldn't even see the guys.
Yeah.
Like, all you had there to go by was the stars.
There we go. Thank you.
Well, I can see.
Yeah, you thought what your mother said was true, huh?
We clear on the left.
Yep.
Clear.
Clear.
Alright, go, 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 go.
Yeah.
Mortars were out of mortars. The artillery was to the point, well, it was pretty much out of artillery, and we were getting low on ammo, so I figured, you know what, we put in a good fight, we might as well pull it out, we might as well pull it out now. You wouldn't even be able to see those choppers coming. All you'd see is when the chopper's like 10 feet off the ground. And then
you saw the dust kick off and went, oh, helicopter's here.
Yeah, exactly. They're ninjas. They just came in and just appeared out of nowhere right in front of us.
Yeah, I will.
Alright, Jake, I'm gonna punch out some safe out of here.
Commander 7 sending in the point, we are off the deck. Damage.
Two of our chopper pilots lost the rotors and then just parked the choppers in the AO.
Yeah,
and that's why at the end you heard me run around yelling at Asworth to blow them all up.
Blow it up. Asworth.
What?
Blow that chopper up.
Okay, let me, hold on. Abra Kitaba, Shiga Dibu, blow that chopper straight up. I command thee, because I'm a Jew.
I like my mouse, right?
Yeah, I don't have like anything to blow it up with.
And they blow it up in two or three?
Fuck, I don't know, man. It's good background music.
L39, it's the adventure, because, you know, you're flying in dark, and then, lo and behold, the whole AO lights up before you, and you've got a few seconds to realign yourself and pray you drop the bomb at the right point.
What the fuck's going on?
Okay, then blow that one up too, Asworth. Find someone to blow it up. Go put grenades on it. I don't care. Do something.
Alright, you see that? Alright, you see that helo at 220? Everybody look at that helo. Stop shooting at it. Or stop shooting and just scream at it. Go.
Hey.
Ah! Jadis is like, oh, blow up the helicopter. I'm like, well, what? Shit, man.
Odd, that's your guys.
My guys are already gone on the last helo.
Hey.
Okay.
Asworth's heroes are still here.
Asworth, your guys, this helo, take them. Well, Holly, you here too?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Watch it. Southwest. We need between the sandbags. Look, we need suppression fire.
Go, load up. Go.
Hey, good luck on that fucking helo, guys.
Most of the airstrikes were bang on. Like, it was hard to see some of them because, you know, they land in the woods in the dark. But whenever I saw those gun runs and saw whatever bombs that I did see hit, they were right on the money, right smack where we wanted them.
No, I'm getting off.
That was odd.
Okay, Impulse, you guys, yeah, listen, odd, all of you guys, load up in this
just
chopper,
pop rounds
load it up.
The trees from time to time, about 6 to 7, 8 seconds apart. Just keep the rounds going out there.
Are the medics staying here?
Yo, medics! Yo, that's the last wounded in this chopper. Not this chopper. Everyone else is taking the next chopper out.
Okay, we need serious light here. We got enemy coming in on us, they're closing fast.
I don't have any paraflares.
The mortars and artillery, they had absolutely no illume rounds left. So it was getting to a point there where all we had left was basically the last remainder of our star shells and the fires and the muzzle flashes basically lighting the way for us.
Yo, Charlie, when's that next chopper coming in?
Shit. Maybe anytime soon. He's working on an airstrike right now.
Well, we need that last chopper. That's our ride. That's the last people here.
We're not going to be able to fit everyone in that one, are we?
Yeah.
Janus, can we fit everyone in that chopper?
We should be able to. There should only be 7 of us here.
Fuck. Keep that light suppression going out there.
Yeah, there's more than
medics,
7, dude.
Same thing with you. Light suppression.
I would like
going.
To stay last.
Where the fuck are those choppers?
Just keep up that light suppression. Oh shit.
Yeah, chopper inbound. Everyone get ready to load.
Watch. I'm hit. Contact. Directly north.
I got
directly
you.
North. At the sandbags. Directly north.
I got you, Milton. Stop moving.
Watch. Someone hit him. Directly north. At the sandbags.
Except my carry.
No, I need to be bandaged.
Except my carry. I'm carrying you to the chopper.
I don't have that.
Let's go.
Yeah, you're on mass wheel.
Oh,
oh
shit!
No way. Even though at the end it was saying mission failed, I'd count that up. I'd chalk that up as a win on our part. That was a successfully played mission. My two main goals for that was, one was to make sure that we accomplished the mission, and simultaneously as a second goal, but just as important as the first one, was to make sure that everyone had fun so that they'd be willing to jump into another event.